If you'd like to learn how to make soul collage cards at home or discover some new soul collage tips or collage techniques, today we will be diving into day 20 of our 30-day art challenge. And if you haven't seen my What is Soul Collage video, definitely check that out here. If you'd like to download the free calendar to join along for the 30-day art challenge, you can find that in the description box below.
We will dive right in.
For today's soul collage cards, I'll be using these two books by Katherine Anderson called Collage Imagery 1 and 3. I love these books because they offer copyright-free imagery, and so it's just a great resource as you're creating your own cards. And today's prompt is Bloom, and so what I'm doing right now is just flipping through the books, and I'm looking for any images which I feel particularly drawn to or repelled by. And that's something I loved that Sina Frost, who created Soul Collage, would always encourage. And I love that she would also talk about that we don't necessarily choose the images, we allow the images to choose us. And so this process of finding your imagery is really freeing. So there's not a lot of thought required. We don't need to understand why we feel drawn to or repelled by a certain image. And so it's really allowing your natural instincts to be heard and for you to just grab those images when you find them. So what I'm doing here is I'm grabbing about 10 images. I recommend anywhere from 5 to 10 images for that particular card or time that you will be creating your soul collage cards. So what's really beautiful about soul collage is that anyone can do this practice. You don't need to be an artist. You don't need to have experience with collaging. If you do, that's fantastic as well. You can put your own creative spin on the process as you make your cards. But there is so much permission in this practice to just be present and notice what is coming up for you. And the understanding of the images comes later at the end. So I'll talk about that later in the video. So right now I'm just taking kind of an overview look at those images that I chose. Because these were pulled directly from the book, I'm just separating some of the images here. These are already sized as 5x8 images, which are perfect for 5x8 soul collage cards and having them on the cardstock. So I'm going to show later in the video how we assemble the cards as well as adhere them onto cardstock and some of my favorite soul collage tips and collage techniques to create smooth images. And cards. So stay tuned for that.
Please definitely subscribe and hit that bell notification so you know when we release our upcoming videos. And please like any videos that really resonate with you. That's a great way for me to know to create more of those kinds for you.
So one thing that I recommend, I just sort of took an overview of a few of the images I felt especially drawn to right now. And this I think a donkey, maybe it's a donkey, with some of the beautiful blooms on it really was calling to me. So I tend to do kind of a rough cut. So I'll roughly work around the image and play around, as you can see here, moving it from different backgrounds. And when I decide 100% that I'm going to use that image, I might go back through and kind of clean up the edges and really cut it out the way that I would like. Another tip is I typically will choose images that I know I'm going to enjoy cutting out. So what I mean by that is sometimes images are so detailed, even though they're really gorgeous, I personally won't enjoy the process of cutting all of the edges. And so that's just something to keep in mind. So here you can see I'm doing that rough cut again. So if I decide or when I decide to use that image of the lotus, I'll go back in and trim all of those edges. But it's just a way I like to save time so I can kind of move through and I know I'll come back to that image later and can cut it out in more detail if I decide to include it on a card. So again, I'm just sifting through about these 10 images I had. I'm noticing which images pair nicely together. Again, I don't need a logical reason for that. It's just what I feel is working in the moment. Here you can see kind of the flower petals and these hands holding eggs. And you might have the thought of, well, what on earth do eggs have to do with blooming? Or that might make sense for you in this moment. You might think of birth or growth. But again, we don't need to understand that as we're making the soul collage card. It really can be about curiosity and play, or just following our artistic creative impulses. So Sina Frost, who created Soul Collage, also has a really beautiful writing practice that's done as the card is finished. And it reminds me of, like, if you're going to have cake, that it's the icing on the cake. And I personally, if I'm going to have cake, I want to have the icing. So the questions and art journaling questions and prompts are, for me, what really make the soul collage practice come alive. So if you're familiar with soul collage, you're probably familiar with the statements, I am the one who, or the message I have for you is. In my online courses and in our live Zoom classes, we have themed classes and we go into a lot deeper inquiry with the soul collage prompts and with sharing reflections with each other. So I definitely would love to have you join the community if you're ever interested. You can find more information on my website at mindfulcreativemuse.com. For today, we're mainly focusing on creating the card. So you can see here I have colored backgrounds for the card stock. I just happened to grab those. I love that I had the yellows and the reds. It always works out serendipitously in that way. And I'm going to give a couple of more soul collage tips and collage techniques as far as assembling the card here. So I have a general idea of how I want my card to be laid out. I always work with my glue stick, having it on the cardstock background first. This glue stick happens to be one where you can see it. So it's purple, but it does dry clear. So I love that it can be really helpful as you're assembling collage art or the soul collage cards. When I'm doing the glue on the magazine paper or a thinner paper, I go in one direction. So you might have noticed on the card, I went in both directions, the card stock, but on the magazine paper, I go in one direction just to avoid any sort of rippage from happening. This is one of my favorite soul collage tips, and I'm using a really firm business card to smooth out the background. So if you've ever noticed, if you make collage art and you've noticed bubbles, this will help eliminate bubbles. It's a great, brilliant tip. When I first learned it many years ago, it changed my world. So I hope it changes yours as well. The other thing I like to do to trim the image is I flip the card over so I can see exactly where the card stock ends and the image begins, and I trim around the edging. So you can always do this at the very end. You can also even keep the collage imagery going off of the card. There's no right or wrong saying it has to be exactly that 5x8 shape. In this case, I do want it trimmed, so that's why I'm flipping it over towards the back. And then as I assemble the images, the smaller images on the card, I do that in a few different ways. In this example, I'm finding my placement, holding it down, and then just kind of peeking it up to glue underneath. The other way you can do it is just having the glue on the back and then kind of placing it over and around. So there's definitely so many different ways you can make soul collage cards. Again, there's no right or wrong, and these are just some tips that I've found to help me work through the process. I would love to hear in comments if you have other favorite ways of assembling your collage art or your soul collage cards. And again, here I'm smoothing out the image, and then I do like to go back over with that firm business card, or you can use a license, anything that's kind of firmer to smooth out the top image. So if that was life-changing for anybody, or that might be overly dramatic, but if that changed your world when it comes to collage art, I'd love to hear in comments as well. Definitely pass that on to others. If you know anybody else who makes soul collage cards, or perhaps they could be inspired or find this practice supportive, definitely please share this video with them as well. So just taking a peek here at the card, I will journal with this later, the I am the one who, and the message I have for you is. If you're brand new to soul collage and you're not sure what I mean by that, no worries, I will be sharing more videos in the future explaining that. These sleeves are really great at protecting the soul collage cards. So I always like to have the little lip at the top where it would be sealed going to the back. So when you're ready, we can always dive into other videos if you want to take a peek at some of my other Soul Collage videos. And definitely join again tomorrow for the rest of our 30-day art challenge.